everyone. In this video of Principles of Management, we would be studying financial management. What are its concept, nature, scope, objective, functional areas, and what are the duties and emerging role of a financial manager in India? So let us start with the video. What is finance? Finance kya hota hai? Finance ek business ka life blood hai, because it is the fund which the organization or the business invests. It is the art and science of managing money. No business can be carried out without the source of finance. Basically, there are several sources of finance, and as such, the finance has to be raised from the right kind of source. Let us come to the definition, which says by R. Solomon that financial management is concerned with the efficient use of an important economic resources, that is the capital fund. Financial management means planning, organizing, directing, and controlling the financial activities, such as to procure and utilize the funds of the enterprise. It refers to the efficient and effective money management, that is the fund, in such a way as to achieve the goal of the organization. Money itself is neither created nor destroyed. It's simply transferred from one perception to another. At its core, the financial management is the practice of making a business plan and then ensuring all the departments stay on track. Solid financial management enables the vice president of the finance to provide data that supports the creation of a long-range vision, informs decisions on where to invest, and yields insights on how to fund those investments, liquidity, profitability, cash runway, and more. Well, financial management is an operational activity which is accountable for the effective utilization of funds necessary for operations. One of the primary objectives of financial management is to maintain enough money to meet the necessary current and capital expenditure apart from maximizing the profit. So the nature of financial management is the main concern with the proper management of funds. And the second one is the financial manager must see that the funds are procured in a manner that there is risk, cost, and control considerations are properly balanced in a given situation, and there is optimum utilization of funds. This is a diagram showing finance. Under finance, there are two activities like financial services and financial management. Financial services includes advisory services, designing financial products, investments on real estates, insurance, etc., personal financial planning. But financial management is the management of finance department in a firm, financial and non-financial, public, private, NGOs, all budgeting, forecasting, cash and credit management, investment analysis, etc. What is the scope of financial management? The scope covers both acquisition and utilization of funds, efficient and wise allocation of funds to various users. So financial management involves providing solutions for major financial operations of a firm. That could be investment decisions, financing decisions, dividend policy decisions. Let us take them one by one. Like investment decision or a function, you can call it as function also. So investment decision relates to the selection of assets that could be fixed or current assets in which the funds will be invested by the firm. So the investment is fixed एंड लॉन्ग टर्म एसेट्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट्स इज कॉल्ड कैपिटल बजटिंग. वॉल्यूम ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, रिटर्न एंड रिस्क एंड रिटर्न्स, कॉस्ट ऑफ कैपिटल एक्सेट्रा. इन्वेस्टमेंट एंड मैनेजमेंट ऑफ करंट एसेट्स इज कॉल्ड वर्किंग कैपिटल मैनेजमेंट. दैट इज मैनेजमेंट ऑफ कैश, इन्वेंट्री एंड रिसीवेबल, profitability and liquidity, etc. The second decision or the function is the financing decision. So financing decision basically kya hota hai? It is concerned with the capital structure decisions of a firm, like creating proper mix between the debt and equity and optimum capital structure, etc. So trade-off between the risk and return. The third one is the dividend policy decision or function, basically deciding the dividend pay out ratio, considering the benefits of shareholders and firm, both. ठीक है, dividend decisions should be analyzed in relation to the financing decision of the firm. Let us now discuss the objectives of financial management. Financial management के दो objectives होते हैं, financial objective and non-financial objectives. जो financial objectives होते हैं वो again तीन part में divided है, that is profit maximization, that is profit after tax, wealth maximization, maximizing EPS, that is earning per share. In financial objectives, first one is profit maximization. Profit maximization ka matlab hota hai maximizing the rupee income of firm. Resources are efficiently utilized, there is appropriate measure of firm's performance. It serves as the interest of society. But there are few objections also to profit maximization, like it should not be vague, it should not ignore the timings of return, it should not ignore the quality of the benefits, etc. The second one is shareholders' wealth maximization, means maximizing the net present value. The fundamental objective is to maximize the market value of the firm's share. Third one is the maximizing EPS, that is earning per share, means ignoring the timings and risk of the expected benefit. Maximizing earning per share will not result in highest price for the company's share. The non-financial objectives are basically like the general welfare of employees, general welfare of society, fulfillment of responsibilities towards the customers, towards the suppliers, then leadership in research and development and effective utilization of funds, etc. The next is the functional areas of finance. The functional areas of finance cover the three areas, that is the personal finance, the corporate finance and the public finance. Jo personal finance hota hai, that is related to the financial position, adequate protection, tax planning, investment and accumulation goals, retirement plans, estimate planning, etc. Whereas jo corporate finance is related to the balancing between the risk and the profitability, then maximizing equities, wealth and stock value, managing the working capital, measuring the performance of portfolio. And public finance is basically related to the sovereign states and its entities, identification of required expenditures, a source of that entity's revenue, etc. So debt insurance for public work projects, etc. So, well, before discussing the duties and responsibilities of the financial manager, I would also say the process of the financial management is to basically first is to assess the current financial position. Second is to define and prioritize the goals. Third is the financial and investment plans. Then fourth one is implementation of the plans. And the last step is to monitor, evaluate and adjust the performance. The various duties and responsibilities which a financial manager has to perform is the related to performing financial analysis and planning, making investment decisions, making financial decisions, etc. Performing financial analysis and planning, under that he has to transforming the financial data into forms which can be used for decisions making, determining the need for additional or reducing finances, etc. In making investment decision, he determine the मिक्स ऑफ करंट एसेट्स एंड फिक्स्ड एसेट्स टू बी हेल्ड बाय द फर्म. देन डिटरमाइन द टाइप ऑफ द एसेट्स इन ईच कैटेगरी. देन लास्ट वन इज मेकिंग फाइनेंशियल डिसीजंस. अंडर दैट द फाइनेंशियल मैनेजर हैज टू डिटरमाइन द शॉर्ट टर्म एंड लॉन्ग टर्म फाइनेंसिंग एंड देर हैज टू बी अ इन डेप्थ एनालिसिस ऑफ अवेलेबल फाइनेंसिंग ऑल्टरनेटिव्स, देयर कॉस्ट एंड लॉन्ग टर्म इम्प्लीकेशंस. लेट अस डिस्कस फ्यू इमर्जिंग और द चेंजिंग रोल due to the globalization, privatization of the finance manager in India is the post-liberalization. The role of the financial manager has become most important, complex and demanding. The industrial licensing abolished and scope of private sector investments has increased. There is abolition of monopoly and restrictive trade practices, that is MRTP. There is abolition of Capital Issue Control Act. There is freedom in designing and issuing securities. Then the market determines the interest rate and exchange rate volatility. Then there is globalization, there is FDI. The investors have become more demanding and assertive. The challenges with the financial manager is facing is related to the regulations, globalization, related to the technology, the risk, the transformation, the stakeholders, management, the strategies, reporting, talent captivities, etc. That's all in this video. Thank you so much.